Hello, good evening students. In this session I am going to explain about properties of rocks. Before that I would like to introduce about the properties of rocks. Different rocks occurring in nature have diverse physical properties and mineralogical compositions. The physical and optical properties like texture and structures of different igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic rocks have been described in the previous chapters. Besides the use of rocks as construction material, all the sites of civil engineering projects like dam, bridges, tunnel, etc. are founded on rocks. This requires the classification of rocks from their use and application point of view to achieve economy and ensure safety and sustainability of the project. The composition, strength, durability, and other properties of construction materials affect the life and economy of a structure. Consequently, it becomes essential to ascertain the engineering properties of rocks. It must be noted that rocks which are useful for one purpose may not be suitable for the other. Hence, a civil engineer must be well versed with the engineering properties of rocks so as to make the right choice of the material for the particular structure. Moreover, the foundations of structures of national importance such as dams, bridges, etc. and linear structures such as tunnels are directly concerned with the geology, rock types and the geological structure encountered. A civil engineer must understand the implications of locating these structures at wrong locations and solve the engineering problems when encountered. The properties of rocks are physical properties like density, porosity, permeability, hardness, abrasivity, and swelling. So, what is this density? Density is a measure of mass per unit of volume. Density of rock material varies. The minerals and their compaction in the rock. However, most rocks are compacted and have specific gravity between 2.5 to 2.8. Non-porous and compact rocks have higher density and toughness. Typical rocks have 3 times the density of that of water, but few rocks with the porous volume have density less than water. Like pumice rock, most rocks that density between 2.5 and 2.8 gram per cubic centimeter. Density of some of the important rock, basalt 3g per cubic centimeter, granite 2.7g per cubic centimeter, and sandstone 2.3g per cubic centimeter. High density rocks like massive gabbro, basalt, and quartzite are very hard, most suitable for foundation purposes. Density of the rock is used to estimate overburden stress. porosity. You can see the image on the screen. The porosity is defined as the ratio of total volume of porous to total volume of the sample. Porosity, therefore, is a fraction that ranges between 0 and 1. Typical porosity ranges from less than 0.01 for solid granite to up to 0.5 for porous sandstone. It may also be represented in percent terms by multiplying the fraction by 100. Since low porosity rocks are generally strong and durable, they are quite favorable for construction and foundation purposes. Some of the example low porous rocks are quartzite, massive granite, marble, etc. Porosity is one of the governing factors for permeability. Porosity proves the voids for water to flow through in a rock material. High porosity therefore naturally leads to high permeability, except clay. Next is permeability. Permeability is a measure of the ability of a material to transmit fluids. Most rocks generally have very low permeability. The permeability of rock material is governed by porosity. Porous rocks such as sandstones usually have more permeability, while granites have very low permeability. High permeability allow fluids and gases to move rapidly through rocks. The permeability of rocks to some extent may be thought to be important structures like dams, reservoirs, etc. Permeability of rock materials except porous rocks, however, has limited interest. It is so because flow in the rock most is concentrated in fractures in the rock mass. You can see on the screen how the rocks are permeable. This on screen you can see the video that movement of the liquid or water. This video showing how connected porous have high permeability and can transport water easily. Water is moving from top to bottom. Note that some porous are isolated and cannot transport water trapped within them. So this is a best example to understand the permeability. Thank you guys.